Mike Jones.
Who?
Mike Jones.
This is the person of the year award recognizes a local business professional who demonstrates leadership and commitment to Fountain Hills community service, volunteerism, and a collaborative spirit. Their efforts contribute to making Fountain Hills a great place to live and thrive. The prestigious recognition celebrates their outstanding contributions to the business community and their dedication in enhancing the well-being of Fountain Hills through their leadership, community engagement, and service. With great honor, I'm going to present the 2024 Business Person of the Year. The Business Person of the Year 2024 is Mike.
Knew that if you came up to him and asked for any kind of help, he was always a yes. He has done so much to serve his community, the community that he loved like no other. And it's with such honor and pride that I accept this award on his behalf. He was so proud that he was nominated. And now I'm even prouder to see him behind with his son, Colin Jones.
Yeah.
Who, he's worked side by side with his father for 13 years and will carry on in the same integrity, honesty, and heart that Discount Air Care has always had. Can you say anything?
Make him proud.
Thank you all for the support. We're going to stay here, take care of our great community, and keep y'all cool.
The flag still stands for freedom.
And they can be middle school or say high school.
Thank you. Please be seated. That will become one of the most precious items that you will ever own. It may not cost a lot of money and value, but in sentimental value, there's nothing greater. My father was in the military, and when he passed away, he received a flag, and it still hangs in our home. And we are so proud of it, and so should you. As you know, we're here this afternoon to celebrate Mike's life. And we're going to have some stories, some tributes, some dedications here in just a few minutes. But Julie asked me to start things off with a reading of the 1 Corinthians chapter 13 as a way of introducing ourselves to Mike and his life and how he lived. Mike was a lover. He loved life. He loved his business. He loved his employees. He loved his kids, his son, he loved Julie. He loved his friends, he loved his family. He loved life. He knew how to have a good time. Just looking at the number of people here this afternoon, coming here tells you how much you meant to him and how many friends he had. And that's because of his love for life. And so Julie asked me to begin by reading 1 Corinthians chapter 13, which we call the love chapter in the Bible. It says, love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. It does not dishonor others, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never ends. Before I just want to say this with regard to grieving and mourning loss. We believe in what we would call a cycle of life. We understand that we are all going to the grave.
We're all going to die at some point. But we also understand that there's this cycle of life.
And we think that people are going to live to be
70 or 80 or 90. Mm-hmm. But then when someone is taken from us at a young age, and he wasn't even 60, he was
still in his mid-50s, something happens to us in our hearts, and we feel like that we have been cheated, and it hurts. And so today, although we're going to celebrate his life, we're going to begin by just admitting that this is a sad day. That we're sad
for his family. We're sad for ourselves.
We are sad because
we lost someone who loved us very much and whom we love very much. When it comes to time to grieve,
God understands us like no one else. God created us in his image. He knows exactly what we go through in life. The one thing every single human being on this planet has in common is we all suffer grief and mourning from the loss of loved ones. It doesn't matter what continent, it doesn't matter what language, it doesn't matter what people group. We all lose people we love. And when we lose them, it hurts. So wouldn't you know that God, in his infinite wisdom,
because he created us, knows exactly how to help us get through the mourning and get to the other side. And so here, just for a couple of minutes this afternoon, what I'm going to do is give you a couple of tools that you can take with you to help you when you are mourning the loss of anyone you love,
whether it be Mike or someone close to you in your family.
First thing God gives us to help us mourn the loss of people we love
is he gives us other people. He gives us other people. You've heard it said that we were created for community. We know what happened in COVID and the struggle that people had when they were separated from community with other people. That's the way God created us. He created us to be with one another. And that's certainly true in good times, but it might even be more true in tough times. There's a saying that I believe is very accurate. It says, if I take a joy and I share it with you, that joy is doubled. But if I take a pain and share it with you, that pain is halved. And so one of the tools that God gives us to walk each other through hard times is He gives us other people. It's interesting because in my job, and I'm a pastor by trade,
so in my job, I watch a lot of people go through pain and mourning, and
I see some people get to the other side, and I see some people get stuck in the mourning process for years and years and years. It's interesting to me, you probably didn't think you were going to hear from Johnny Cash this afternoon, but Johnny gave us a profound quote when he said this: there is no way around grief and loss. You can dodge it all you want, but sooner or later you must have to go through it, into it, and hopefully come out on the other side. The world you find there will never be the same as the world you love. So when we lose someone that we love like mine, we are put here now in an opportunity where we make a decision about what happens with the rest of our lives. And intuitively, what we want to do is we just want to shut down. We want to turn off the phone. We want to shut the shades. Just leave me alone. I just want to hurt. And although that makes sense in our mind, that's exactly the opposite of the way God designed us. God designed us to look at the pain in the face, and you don't run from it. You don't get super busy so you don't have to address it. You don't shut people out so you don't have to talk about it. Actually, the best way through pain is to lean into it. You lean into it. And how do you lean into it? You walk through it with other people.
And so specifically,
Julie, for you and for Rob, this is what I would like to give you as a piece of advice. In the days ahead, talk about him. Talk about him. Cry with other people.
Wear your emotions on the sleeve.
Tell stories about my
work. We're going to hear some great stories
tonight. We need to keep telling stories.
What I would encourage all of you to do is text and call and email these guys. Let them
know you care about them. Let them
know you're thinking about them. Invite them to have a conversation. Go drink coffee with them.
Have a texting conversation, because God created us in such a way that every time I tell a story,
every time I cry, every time I
lean into that pain with someone I love, God just supernaturally
mends my broken heart one stitch at a time. And so what I want to encourage you guys to do is moving forward, to be a community, to be a family. Walk through this together. Share your stories. Share your stories. And that's going to help these guys heal from their broken hearts.
So it is now time to start the tributes. I'm going to ask
Rob to come up. Rob, you ready
to get us started?
Today, privileged to be able to say I knew my Jones. He was my best friend, and our relationship was one I will cherish for the rest of my life. I would like to share some of the highlights of our time together on this earth. I knew Mike in two aspects of his life, one being business, the other being human side. The side that I'm not sure all of you, or many of you, have ever got to see. Mike and I met in the most funniest ways. Mike was known as a hard ass in our industry. I never met him until 2007, but when he overheard me cussing out a man in a wheelchair, something triggered. There's a guy I want to get to know. The fact is, the guy in the wheelchair was a regular customer, and we often cussed at each other. It was a back and forth thing, it was a humorous thing. Mike told me later, though, he thought that was one of the funniest things he ever witnessed in his life. Our relationship grew over time. After that, his business grew as my career also started to grow. Our business relationship was built on both of our core beliefs. Be on time, go above and beyond for our customers, have integrity in everything we do, and most importantly, Mike and I cared about each other's success. Mike and I were very much the same. It was no mistake that we became best friends outside of work. One story I have to tell, I can't even tell it. This is why we're friends. It was a factory tour in Tyler, Texas. We just got done with the tour and we wanted to get a drink. Problem was, we didn't have nowhere to get there. We were stuck at the hotel. So us being salesmen, we literally sold the fact that, hey, we're gonna borrow the hotel's front desk clerk. We borrowed her car, went to the store. This is not the funny part. The funny part is, we get to the store and it's a dry counter. we didn't know that. But that's also not the funny part. The funny part was, we get back in the car and the car wouldn't start. So there we are, we're laughing at first, now we're screaming, now we're kicking. And it's good times, man. It's one I'll always remember. A couple other fun facts. Dude loved to dance. He always made me look bad in front of the ladies, man. Dude could dance. He was also, he also loved blackjack, but I would tell you, he had a very unorthodox style. He ran most people off the table. His favorite moves were split tens, double down on 12s and 13s, and then always stay on 15 if the dealer's showing a 10. Like, that's my boy. Dude always won, though. So he also replied to me and others in text. He texts cool, right? It started with a K. That's because he loved cool again. That's what that meant. Anybody didn't know. Mike was a lot of things to many people, but for me, I can sum it up like this. Mike was a brilliant businessman. He can make you laugh and he can make you cry. He's a good father, good husband, and to me, the best friend a guy could ever ask for. 2 days before Mike passed, he raised his middle finger to me one last time, and today I'm gonna do it back.
All right, I just want to start off by thanking everybody for coming out here. I'm Mike's son, Conlon, if any of you do not know. But past that point, I'd like to say he loved all of you, and you guys are a fantastic community, and we are so happy to be here and have the support that we do. Family, friends, everybody around, it's just wonderful what everybody's able to do. And I just wanted to thank you for that. And you all know your own special stories everybody's had with Mike, you know, how he's either helped you, made you laugh, made you angry, you never know. But it was always a special privilege having him as a mentor and being able to move on forward with his legacy and being able to take care of this wonderful community. I just want to thank everybody.
I won't be so short. Though I was short last night in the acceptance speech. If you guys didn't see on Facebook, I'm so proud of my husband. He won Business Person of the Year for 2024. I think that in and of itself speaks highly of who he is. So, dear Mike, I wrote a story about you, but you helped a lot. Because you're you. This means I obviously had some great material to work with, so it was easy to come up with lots to say about the incredible person you are, the wonderful things you do, and all the ways you are completely, ridiculously, perfectly unlike anyone else. And you know what? It turned out to be an excellent story, and not just because I wrote it. It's excellent because you're you. And in my story, that is the best. I have put some thought into this, and I want to tell you the following things. You are always completely and effortlessly all about other people, especially when it comes to family and friends, friends that you consider family. You put yourself last, making sure that the people you love are taken care of first. You are a champion for what is right, and you love deeply. If you were an animal, you'd be a tiger, fiercely protective with a cuddly, gentle side. And if you were a color, you'd be yellow, the bright light in all of our lives. You shine so, so bright in our life. And if you were a superhero, you'd be Captain America. You're honest, upfront, loyal, extremely noble, and always dependable. I'd love to celebrate all of my favorite things about you, which of course are your sense of humor, a love for adventure, your protectiveness, gentleness, and being the biggest cheerleader in my life and the lives of your family. You lead by example that anything is possible when you put your heart into it and always exceed expectations. One of the most wonderful things about having you in my life is seeing you smile, laugh, and love me unconditionally. In our world, we took vacations to Italy, Vietnam, Australia, New Zealand, New Orleans, New York City, San Antonio, Lambeau Field, Kauai, but my most favorite of all, Newport Beach, which brought you tears of happiness. Your smile at the water that day lit up the beach like a beacon of a lighthouse. You know what never fails to make me smile? Thinking about the time in Italy that we went on the wrong way on the freeway. You are going the wrong way. They're crazy. Yeah, how do they know which way we are going? Do you know that movie? It's one of our favorite movies watched every day on Thanksgiving Day. We spent 8 hours in a tiny airport in New Zealand, just you and I, making memories after we were flooded out on part of our trip. I always said we could have fun in a wet paper bag as long as we were together. At our wedding, dancing to our favorite song that I surprised you with during the ceremony, and flying to New York for a one-day date. I, for one, am truly grateful that you picked me and loved me so much. And despite the heartbreaking loss of losing you, I would do it all over again to know that love and friendship we shared. I think it would be absolutely impossible for anyone who's known you for any time at all not to notice that you're utterly exceptional at giving of your heart so generously and always saying yes to helping out those in need, especially children in foster care, rescue dogs, and the elderly. In fact, when you sensed a need, you were there to support it in any way you could. If I had the power to rearrange the world just a little bit, I would make sure you could spend more time with those that love and adore you, and much, much less time in pain and sickness. I probably didn't tell you this enough, but the one thing I want you to always, always know is that I have always, will always love you. In spite of our rocky times and the challenges we faced, I never stopped loving you, nor will I stop loving you. You have always had my heart, and you always will. When I look at your picture and think of you and our time together, I'm in so much gratitude that you picked me to walk our life together for the last 13 years, 2 months, and 25 days. You continue to walk with me as I feel your presence in everything I do. I wish I still had 1,000 moments that I had just taken for granted, mostly because I had assumed there would be 1,000 more. Our pictures tell part of our love story, a love story of mutual respect, support, fun, laughter, adventures, and being each other's best friend. They don't tell the tenderness and tears we shared, especially when we learned of your diagnosis, or the love notes and letters we wrote to each other throughout our partnership. Those memories will always be held in a sacred part of my heart. I found this quote that sums you up, There is so much to tell about you. The video that we will play next is a tribute to a life well lived. I know the celebration of you is a reflection of all that mattered most to you and truly speaks of who you are. At the end of life, what really matters is not what we brought, but what we built. Not what we got, but what we shared. Not our competence, but our character. And not our success, but our significance. Live a life that matters. Live a life of love. I am forever and will be your sunshine. Gone from my sight. I am standing upon the seashore, a ship at my side, spreads his white sails to the moving breeze and starts for the blue ocean. He is an object of beauty and strength. I stand and watch him until at length he hangs like a speck of white cloud just where the sea and sky come to mingle with each other. Then someone at my side says, there, he is gone. Gone where? Gone from my sight. That is all. He is just as large in mass, hull and spar, as he was when he left my side. And he is just as able to bear his load of living freight to his destined port. His diminished size is in me, not in him. And just at that moment, when someone says, there, he is gone, there are other eyes watching him coming and other voices ready to take up the glad shout. Here he comes, and that is dying. In your bag, you were given a pen and a challenge coin. Let me explain the challenge coin for those who don't know. A challenge coin is a small coin or medallion bearing an organization's insignia or emblem and carried by the organization's members. Traditionally, they might be given to prove membership when asked and to enhance morale. They are also collected by service members and law enforcement personnel. They've been an American military tradition for a century, meant to instill unit pride, improve esprit de corps, and reward hard work and excellence. Historically, challenge coins were presented by unit commanders in recognition of special achievement by a member of the unit. They could also be exchanged in recognition of visits to an organization. Modern day challenge coins may feature popular culture attributes or organizational values. Modern challenge coins are made in a variety of sizes and are often made using popular culture references, including superheroes. To me, Mike Jones is a superhero. To his family, friends, and clients, he embodies the spirit of kindness, generosity, integrity, and love. My challenge to you today is to embody the spirit of Mike Jones and to spread kindness and generosity wherever you go. Be like Mike.
Will forget what you said, people will forget what you did, but people will never forget how you made them feel. A quote by Maya Angelou. I am Carol, one of many of Julie Jones's best friends. I'm honored that I get to share a few of my favorite memories of Mike. Of course, I have to start with the many Halloween parties. His birthday party where Prancer magically appeared and instantly became part of their family. Playing bingo at the American Legion, making a human pyramid at Cervana after attending a seminar, attending and supporting many of my comedy fundraisers, and inviting me over last minute for Christmas dinner when my flight suddenly was canceled. As I reflect on the outside, looking into Mike's life, he truly lived, and his legacy will remain in so many ways. From traveling from sea to shining sea, from Australia to Vietnam, where Mike and Julie visited friends and were honored to be named godparents to Jasmine and Jones. Yes, Jones was named after Mike. Mike was an entrepreneur and hard worker, which provided him many of the finer things in life. He loved to travel, loved arts and entertainment, loved fine dining, and enjoyed cooking, especially on his grill. I enjoyed many fabulous meals with Mike, from his grilled sea bass that melted in your mouth, to our peel and eat shrimp, and slurping down oysters sitting on the dock of the bay in beautiful Milwaukee. Mike loved to volunteer and used his time, talent, and resources, from playing Santa Claus for OCJ kids, to storing and delivering hundreds of teddy bears, toys, and items for volunteer organizations that were dear to his heart. He was one of the most generous men that I knew. And like the quote of Maya Angelou, it was the way that Mike made me feel when I was around him. He always made me feel special. Although Mike may have been a man of few words, it was evident that his actions, that his giving, generous, and kind heart were enormous. It was apparent that he loved his family, his mom, his son Conlon. I know you truly made him proud. And the way he took care of his guys and his business, to the way he loved and contributed to his community in Fountain Hills, words cannot express the loss that we all feel. And to you, Julie, Mike Sunshine, witnessing you through this journey, especially over the last 6 months, I'm so grateful that I get to stand beside you and witness what it truly means to keep your vows, from sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, to death do us part. As your world crumbled, you handled every single moment with beauty, grace, and unconditional love. Your transparency and heartbreak were felt by all of us. However, we also saw your incredible strength, gratitude, and love. I know your heart has been shattered into a million pieces, and as I learned from you, grief is the price you pay for love. As I kept hearing you say after Mike passed, in lieu of flowers and food, you just really wanted Mike's legacy and honor to stay alive. With the help of Betsy at the Fountain Hills Chamber, and on behalf of a few of your best friends, named in alphabetical order, Allie, Colleen, Debbie, Erica, Lindy, Karen, Myrna, Rosie, Sherry, and myself, we want to help you keep Mike's legacy alive as we purchased an engraved stainless steel piece in loving memory of Mike Jones for the Arizona State Donor Puzzle. The 8 feet tall piece of work, almost as tall as you, will contain 99 puzzle pieces that complete the state of Arizona. It will be displayed at the Centennial Pavilion shade structure that's going to be located in between the community center and the Fountain Hills Library. It will read, "Love is Forever, Mike and Julie Jones." The Fountain Hills Chamber is also holding a fundraiser called Climatize the Patio, Building an Enduring Business Legacy in Fountain Hills. With their membership growth on this patio, they will be building a comfortable, exclusive environment for the community to connect, communicate, and grow. With your support and donation, we can honor Mike with a laser-engraved brushed stainless steel black plaque in his name. They look like that over there. I felt this was a great way to honor Mike, where people will be celebrating on this patio for many years to come, where we can keep his name, spirit, and legacy alive. I have some information here, and I'm gonna leave it on that table out there. And if you are willing to donate a small portion, I know we've asked you to give a lot. However, I thought that this is such an appropriate place. It's gonna be a covered patio where people are gonna be celebrating. And I'm sure Mike would have been one of the people that would have been putting the misting system in for that as well. As I know this will not mend all the pieces of your broken heart, Julie, however, it may help as a reminder to you of a puzzle piece that fit perfectly in your love story that you shared with Mike. I know that I'm always here for you, for a listening ear, a shoulder to cry on, a new emergency contact person, or just to pour some unconditional love onto you. I want to close with a quote that helped me get through grief many times in my life. The reality is that you will grieve forever. You will not get over the loss of a loved one. You will learn to live with it. You will heal and you will rebuild yourself around that loss you have suffered. You will be whole again, but you will never be the same. Nor should you be the same, nor would you want to. Grief is the price that you pay for love. And reflecting back, it definitely makes it feel a little bit more worth the pain, tears, and tremendous heartbreak.
Mike Jones. Who? Mike Jones.
Feelings hard to conceal. Can't imagine all the pain I feel. Give anything to hear half your breath. I know you're still living your life after death.
Every day we pray for you, till the day we meet again.
in my heart is where I keep you, friend. Memories give me the strength I need to proceed, strength I need to believe. My thoughts big, I just can't define. Wish I could turn back the hands of time. Us in the six, shop for new clothes and kicks. You and me taking flicks, making hits. Stages they receive you on, still can't believe you're gone. Give anything to hear half your breath. I know you're still living your life after death.
Because big time Tetsu sounds. Who got up? Yeah! Welcome, butter.
Welcome to this place, I'll show you everything. take her by my side. We're standing on, we created land. We're on wide open under the sunlight. Welcome to this place, I'll show you everything. We're lungs wide open, now everything has changed. I'll show you it all, I'll show you everything. We're lungs wide open. You give your hand to me, and then you say hello, and I can hardly speak. My heart is beating so, and anyone can tell. You think you know me well, well, you don't know me. No, you don't know the one who dreams of you at night and longs to kiss your lips and longs to hold you tight. Oh, oh, I'm just a friend, that's all I've ever been, 'cause you don't know me. For I never knew the art of making love, though my heart aches with love for you. Afraid and shy, I let my chance go by, a chance that you might love me too. Give your hand to me, and then you say goodbye. I watch you walk away beside the lucky guy. Oh, you'll never know the one who loved you so. Well, you don't know me.
This world just fade away. Do rock, paper, scissors first.
That was a great tribute to Mike Slack, wasn't it? Every one of those pictures was a memory, and a lot of you people were in those pictures. It was wonderful. I've got some good friends, Mark and Myrna, that were in several of those pictures, and I know that was very special for you. I want to close out by just reading the 23rd Psalm. I want to remind you, the Lord created us, and because of that, He knows how to heal our broken hearts. And I told you earlier that one of the ways we do that is through other people. The other one is through God. The Holy Spirit in Scripture is actually called the Comforter. And one of the things God is very good at is comforting people who hurt. And I know with the loss of Mike, we're going to hurt for a while. But I want you to know God is there with you every step of the way. He created you. He loves you. He cares about you. And He's never going to leave you. He's going to walk with you through the entire journey of healing. And so in the days ahead, when you want to really wrap your head around what's going on, and there's not a friend there, you have a friend in God. Pray to him. Talk to him. Tell him where your heart is. And what he will do is he'll mend your broken heart. The 23rd Psalm says, "The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures, leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. And even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will not fear, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." Let's pray. Father, what a wonderful tribute to a great man we've had over the last hour. Thank you for every story. Thank you for every picture. Thank you for the comforting words that have been spoken here today. Thank you for everything Julie said in that letter that really helped us see the heart of Mike. And Lord, we're now walking through the valley of the shadow of death. And it hurts and it's painful. But you've said we don't have to fear because you're with us. You're right here comforting us. And so that's what I pray for this family and these friends. Lord, in the days ahead, give them comfort. Give them peace. Mend their broken hearts. And yes, Lord, we know that the world's not ever going to be the same without Mike in it. But that doesn't mean we have to stay stuck here. That we can move forward to healing. We can take his memory with us as we live a full and abundant life in the days ahead. Do your healing work, O God. In Jesus' name, amen.